Hello, this is Yogesh Singh from IIC Bangalore. So in this video, we'll see the solution of the problem I provided you in the last video. But before that, I want to give you detailed information about the diode. So let us see this diode, which is a two-terminal device. It has two terminal. One is A, that is anode. And another is K, that is cathode. Okay, so based on the analysis of this diode, we can bifurcate it into two parts. One is AC analysis, another is DC analysis. For an AC analysis, this diode is represented by one resistor, say RD, and two capacitors. One is called CT, that is transition capacitor. Another is called CD, that is diffusion capacitor. So in DC analysis, it is represented by its cut-in voltage and one resistor, let us say RF. And its current voltage is V gamma. When this RF is very small, in that case, it is only represented by its current voltage. V gamma. So this is about DC analysis. Further, in AC analysis, we again bifurcate it in two parts. One is called high frequency analysis. Another is low frequencies. So at high frequencies, this capacitor impedance XC equals to 1 by SC. Since this frequency is very high, so this will come in picture. Okay, but in low frequencies, this XC equals to 1 by SC is very high, almost infinity. So in that case, this capacitors CT and CD are open circuit. Now my diode is simply represented by this RD, where RD is dynamic resistor RD is dynamic resistance. Which is eta VT by ID plus I naught, where ID is forward bias diode current, I naught is reverse bias saturation current of the diode, VT is the thermal voltage, and eta is ideality factor, which tells that how much close my diode is to ideal diode in terms of its behavior. So this is about DC analysis. When this I naught is very small, that is reverse saturation current is very small as compared to ID, that is ID much much greater than I naught, in that case this RD is simply eta VT by ID. So this is the formula we all have been mugging up. Ultimately we have been using this formula only, but we should know the story behind this formula and the detailed analysis of the diode in AC and DC analysis, because you never know when IIT professor will ask the question from this story only. So this much level of crystal clarity in the concept you are supposed to have while appearing in GATE 2022. Now let us say I am applying a voltage. This is my diode. Okay, so I am applying voltage let us say voltage applied across diode D. This is say D. Voltage applied across diode is VA. Now let us see it in new page. Now this is the voltage axis. Okay, I'm applying voltage VA across the diode. This is zero. Say this is the cut-in voltage of diode V gamma. Now when the voltage is less than zero, when the voltage in this range, then the diode is in reverse bias and we have capacitor CT. Similarly, when diode is forward bias, means the voltage across diode is greater than its cut-in voltage V gamma, in that case diode have a capacitor C diffusion. But in this range, when the voltage applied across diode is between 0 and V gamma, in that case we have both CT and C diffusion. So this is all about the diodes, and we'll see the solution of the problem. Now to solve this problem, now one thumb rule I'm gonna give you is, whenever you see a problem of diode, be it any simple diode or it is a GNR diode, it is BJT, the very first thing should come in your mind is you do not have information about your devices, whether it is on or off. So let us assume it off, and the moment you assume it off, you make it open circuit and then you find the voltage across the diode. If it is greater than its cut-in voltage, in that case you make it turn on, otherwise you leave it turn off and solve the circuit. So we are going to do the same thing in this circuit. So let us see the first problem. So the first problem is, we have a 3 volt battery connected. One diode is connected here and one 0.5k and then 2.5k. 10.5K resistor is connected there, and 2.5K resistor is connected here. So the thumb rule you have to apply is, I do not know the information about my device whether it is on or off. Let us assume it off. So I'll assume this diode off and make it open circuit. Let us say this is the VA anode terminal voltage, this is VK cathode terminal voltage, and we know the cut-in voltage of diode is 0.7 volt. So this is VA, this is VK, and here we have registered this 2.5K. Now I'll find out VA and VK, and then I'll get VAK, and I'll compare this VAK with its cut-in voltage V gamma. Okay, so VK, now this current will not go here, the entire current will come here. So current will come here like this, and it will flow through this 2.5K. Now I'll find out this voltage VK. This two resistors are connected in series, and I'll apply VDR, voltage division rule here. VDR. Now I'll find VK equals to 2.5K divided by 0.5K plus 2.5K into total voltage, that is 3 volt. I get 2.5 divided by 3 into 3. So 3 cancel out. I get 2.5 volt. This is VK. And I know this VA, this is short circuit to this 3 volt battery. So VA is 3 volt. Now I find out VAK, voltage across diode, equals to VA VAK equals to VA minus VK, that is 3 minus 2.5 equals to 0.5 volt. So I got VAK equals to, I got 0.5 volt, but I had V gamma, current voltage of diode was 0.7 volt. So I see VAK is less than V gamma. So diode will remain off. And since diode will remain off, I have this circuit now. 3 volt battery, this path is off, and here I have 0.5K resistor, and here I have 2.5K resistor, and current is flowing through this resistor is I. Now this is in series, I can find out current equals to voltage is 3 volt battery is connected divided by total resistance is 0.5K plus 2.5. So I get I equals to 3 by 3 milliampere, that is 1 milliampere. So the answer for the first question is 1 milliampere. Similarly for the second question, we had 2.5K here and 0.5K here. Let us see this problem also. Question number 2, we had a battery plus minus 3 volt battery is here, one diode was connected here, the diode is having cut-in voltage 0.7 volt, one resistor, this is 2.5K this time, and another resistor here, this is 0.5K. Okay, so again, I do not know my device. I do not, so again, I do not know about my device whether this diode is on or off. So I will assume it off. Then I'll make it open circuit. This terminal will be VA, this terminal will be VK. This battery is connected 3 volt and this diode is connected 2.5K and this resistor 0.5K. So again, the entire current will come from here. This will go like this and come here. So this 2.5K and 0.5K is in series. Now again, I'll apply VDR. I'll apply VDR and find out this VK. VK I get 0.5K divided by 0.5K plus 2.5K into total voltage 3 volt. Equals to I get 0.5 divided by 3 into 3. 3 cancel out equals to 0.5 volt. And this 3 volt is VA here. So VA I get 3 volt. Now in this case I get VAK equals to VA minus VK. That is 3 minus 0.5. So VAK I get 3 minus 0.5 volt, that is 2.5 volt. But we had V gamma, that is current voltage of the diode was 0.7 volt. This time VAK, that is 2.5 volt, is greater than 0.7 volt. Now diode will be on. So diode will be on, then we will replace it by its cut-in voltage 0.7 volt. Since RF is not given, RF is 0, so we will replace it by its cut-in voltage 0.7 volt. Now let us see the circuit. I would have 0.7 volt here. One battery was connected of 3 volt here. Here I have 2.5K resistor and again 0.5K. So the current I have to find out. So I know the voltage across this to 0.7 volt. So I'll apply KCL here like this in this loop. What I get is 3 minus 0.7 volt across this 0.7 minus current I into this resistor I into 0.5 equals to 0. This is the KVL I applied. By solving it, I get 3 minus 0.7 equals to 0.5 I. So I get 2.3 by 0.5 milliampere. So by solving it, I get 4.6 milliampere. So question number 1, answer we got I equals to it was 1 milliampere. For question number 2, we got I equals to 4.6 milliampere. So in the comment section, there was one person, Kirato. So his answer is correct, 1 milliampere and 4.6 milliampere. So this is all about this video. If you have any doubt, any suggestion you want me to make video upon, you can always let me know in the comment section. I'll be sure to check it out. And you keep preparing, you keep working hard and keep solving lot of good quality problem. Thank you.